Hello and welcome to this video on database migration testing. Data migration testing is a backend testing. In this testing tutorial, we will learn the basics of data migration testing scope, testing approach, what to put in a database migration testing bug report, database testing challenges, and possible solutions. First, what is database migration? It means the movement of data from an old database or databases to a new database. We refer to the old database as a source database or legacy database. We call the new database the target database or the destination database. We use an automated ETL, meaning extract, transform, and load process to do the DB migration. The ETL tool also has business rules to increase data quality. Next, why do we do database migration testing? The reasons include checking. Is each business rule implemented correctly in the ETL tool? Are all live entities, meaning not expired entities, for example, customer records and order records, migrated to the correct tables in the target database? Each live entity should be migrated exactly once. We also need to check, is each attribute of each live entity in the source database migrated to the target database or not? Does the DB migration process work quickly? Now let us see the database migration testing approach. It consists of the following activities. First, we design the validation tests. The validation tests include SQL queries to test database migration. We need these validation queries to cover the ETL testing scope explained in the previous slide. We need queries for both the source and the target databases. We should order our queries. For example, we should first test if all the customer records are migrated, and only then test if all the order records are migrated, because the order records depend on the customer records. Next, we set up the test environment because we test the database migration in a test environment. Our test environment should contain the source database copy, the ETL tool, and as needed, a blank or partially populated target database. Then we run the database migration process under test. Then we run our validation tests. Finally, we analyze test results and report the defects. Now let us see the data that we should include in every database migration testing defect report. The entity that failed, total number of rows or columns that failed, the validation test query that we used, database error number and description, if any, the user account that we used to log into the source and target databases, the date and time of the database migration run, and the date and time of our validation test query run. Now let us see some potential problems and solutions in database migration testing or ETL testing. The first challenge is that the source data may change during the test. Possible solution is that we should back up the source and target databases. This would help if we need to restart the database migration. The second problem is that the source data is partially corrupt. For example, some source data is incomplete or contains junk values. Here, the possible solution is that the ETL tool should handle the corrupt data. Our validation test should confirm the ETL's handling of corrupt data. Another problem is that the source target mapping across tables and fields may change. The possible solution is we should write validation tests for stable or unchanged mappings first. and we should write validation tests for the remaining mappings when they are finalized. Another potential problem is that the data migration fails, but partially. This can happen if part of the source data is accepted and the other part is rejected. The possible solution is we need to find out the failing data. We can do this if we have modular validation queries, which we can run one by one. The last potential challenge is that the data migration may take a lot of time to complete. This can happen if the source data is huge or the ETL process is complex. In order to resolve this problem, we could include our validation queries in the ETL tool so that they are run automatically. Now let us see if you know about database migration testing or you should view this video again. So here are some questions and answers. In database migration testing, what is the final or resulting database called? It is called the target database or the destination database. What is ETL? ETL means extract, transform, and load. It is a process that queries the source data, checks it according to business rules, transforms data if needed, and then loads data into the target database. What do we test in database migration? In other words, what is the ETL testing scope? We test, is each business rule implemented in the ETL correctly? Have all live source entities migrated to the target database? Have all attributes of every live entity migrated to the target database? And is the ETL reasonably fast? What data do we put in an ETL testing bug report? The important data includes the name of the failed entity, for example, order details or some other entity that failed, the total number of rows and columns that failed, the validation query that we used, and the error number and description. Database migration testing is a type of database testing. In this ETL testing tutorial for beginners, we learned what is DB migration, what is the database testing scope to test if it was a successful data migration, database testing approach to test data migration, and what to put in every ETL testing bug report. Then we learned about some data testing problems and solutions and questions and answers to test our knowledge of database migration testing. That's all in this video. Thank you and see you in my other videos.